Okay, in this video, I'm going to show you how to register a free website name, how to host it and design everything without even spending a penny, so you can start working on your ideas right away. First, you'll need to visit a website called freenom.com. This is where you can get various domain names for free. Type in the name that you want and check if it's available. Let's say I want my website to be named Emit.Reviews. Then click around on these to check if any of them are available for free. That's weird. All of them seem to be not available. Or that's what they want you to think. If you type in the full domain name you want, you'll be able to get it anyways. Then just click checkout and choose the maximum available period, which is 12 months. You'll now need to register an account and fill in all of this information. Once you're done, you will be able to see your domain name registration by going into services and clicking on My Domains. As you can see here, the domain is registered, but it doesn't load anything. Well, that's because we haven't hosted anything on it yet. It's just a simple name registration. With the free options, your domains will always look sort of weird, with the .ga or .tk extensions. If you want a .com, .net, or .org or something like that, you'll have to buy it. You can do so by clicking the link in the description. This will take you to Hostinger, where you'll be able to get a .com name for $9 a year, or something like a .online or .xyz for just 99 cents a year, which is like practically free. But since I'm doing a free tutorial this time, I'm just gonna continue with my .ga name and see where it gets us. To get web hosting for free, you'll need to visit 000webhost.com and click Get Started. Then choose the free option, sign up for an account, and you'll be on your way. The very first thing you'll need to do is click Create New Site. The website name and password doesn't really matter here, it's just how it's going to look in your dashboard. So you can change these if you want or just click Create. Once your website is created, click on it and choose Manage Website, then click Install next to WordPress option. Choose the login information you'll use to reach your WordPress account and click Install once again. Then simply wait for the installation to finish. So once the installation is finished, your website will look something like this, which is not very impressive yet. And it's still using the default name, so now let's use the name we got earlier and link it with this website that we have right now. To link the domain names, you'll want to go into Freenom and click Manage Domain. Then choose Management Tools and click on Name Servers. Next, choose Use Custom Domain Servers. Keep this window open and go into 000 Webhost. Click Manage Website, go into the Tools tab and choose Set Web Address. Then click on Park Domain and copy-paste the two name servers that 000 Webhost gave you into Freenom Name Server fields. Once you copy-pasted both name servers, click Change Name Servers. This might require you to log in again and confirm. The last step is going back into 000 Webhost and typing in your Freenom domain. For me, it's emit.reviews.ga. And clicking Park Domain. You'll now see this appear next to the linked websites, and if we would click on our website name, now the web hosting and the website name are linked together. Okay, so we finally linked our free website name with the free hosting we got from 00 Webhost, but we still got a couple of steps left. First of all, gotta get rid of that design and add our own. You might be surprised, but adding the design is going to be really easy. All you need to do is, in the browser, type in your website name followed by slash login and use the login information you created earlier. Then hover over Appearance and click Themes. As you can see here, there are several themes already installed, but we don't want any of them. It's better to delete what we're not using, so switch to some other theme and then click on Shapely and click Delete right here in the corner. The thing with free web hosting plans is that they're seriously limited, so we want to be as conservative as possible and delete everything we don't need. Then click Add New at the top, search for a theme called Astra, click on Install, and once that's done, click Activate. Once activated, just click Get Started, choose Elementor, and browse the free templates. Choose whichever one you like best, there's honestly quite a lot to pick from, and simply click Import Complete Site. Then wait for the installation to finish. Okay, it looks like we've got an error during installation. This might happen a lot. If this happens, try going into plugins and adding the plugin that it got stuck on manually. Sometimes even that doesn't help, as you'll still get an error. Why does this happen exactly though?
Because free web hosting is the worst. While filming this video, I had to repeat steps that usually should take like 2 to 3 minutes for hours until I could get it working the way it's supposed to work. And I can't stress this enough, how not worth it it is to use free web hosting when hosting an actual website, not just learning. And even for learning purposes, it's kinda tricky because the things you learn are not applicable on paid plans, because paid plans are just so much easier to use. If you're serious about your website, don't use free web hosting. Use cheap web hosting instead. Because here's the deal. What you save in terms of money on free web hosting, you'll spend 10 times the amount of that in terms of time getting everything set up properly. Just get yourself some cheap web hosting plans that are gonna cost you less than $10 per year. I have videos detailing the best cheap web hosting providers right here. And I also have tutorials on how to set them up in like 10 or 15 minutes for the best possible performance.
But if you're really crazy enough to continue with free hosting, I did find the way around the error. Sometimes. You'll have to go into your 000 web host dashboard, then click Manage Site, go into Tools and click File Manager. Then click on Upload Files and navigate to the Plugins folder. Here, just select WooCommerce or any other plugin that your installation got stuck on and delete it. Then go back into WordPress and try installing that plugin manually again. And then try continuing the installation to see if everything's working properly this time.
As I mentioned before, free web hosting is a nightmare to work with, and it will keep annoying you with these small things that should work the first time you do it, but for some reason they don't. And nobody bothers fixing them because, well, it's a free service. So just get cheap web hosting plans.
Okay, so it looks like I finally got it to work after some tries. I have the website fully designed and the name attached to it. Of course, the name isn't pretty and the loading speed isn't amazing, but it gets the job done for a free service.
And I'm sure stuff will break in the process as well, because I found free web hosting services to be quite inconsistent. One day it's working perfectly fine, the other days I just can't seem to set it up properly. So I wish you luck getting your free web hosting services up and running, because trust me, you'll need it. I'm gonna go get some more.